Africa is rising, driven by innovative entrepreneurs skilled in overcoming the challenges of underperforming infrastructure, political instability, and a negative international image. African brands, no doubt, need a boost, and to actualize this, a platform to promote and raise awareness of their brands became imperative.
The primary objectives of the African Brands Awards is really to try to, we are creating a platform. So the African Brands Awards itself is a global platform where we are seeking to not only raise awareness and promote African brands, but also to showcase those African brands that are already making impact in Africa, that are already making impact in some parts of the world, but more importantly, those brands that are going to be the key movers and shakers, if you like, in the next 5 to 10 years. Okay. So this is really an opportunity for those brands to project beyond their immediate environment, be it Nigeria or West Africa or Africa, but onto a global stage.
According to reports by World Economic Forum, Africa has 7 of the top 10 fastest growing economies, with the trend expected to continue over the next 5 to 10 years. This economic growth in Africa countries has been attributed to contributions of the Africans in diaspora, increased educational attainment, and use of information technology. On ways Africa can sustain this growth, the executive chairman of African and Caribbean Chamber of Commerce and Enterprise, Fola Kudehimbu, speaks again.
I wouldn't necessarily say that it's a lack of competitiveness. We should be careful not to compare oranges with apples here. You know, you have a lot of global brands that have been in Africa for a long time, and they've actually created those brand awareness. And so a lot of people identify those brands. And what we're having to do in Africa, most African countries, including Nigeria, is to start from scratch, where we are creating our own brands. And it takes a long time to create brand awareness, to create that sort of emotive connection that consumers have with brands. And so in terms of that, African products, we need to obviously develop, and we need to, especially in terms of the quality of it, but we should understand that we shouldn't really be comparing ourselves with brands that have been around for 100, 200 years, because I don't think that's a fair comparison.
The perception of the entire world about African-made product is simple. African brands are fake and substandard. This has presented African business, both locally and internationally, in a bad light. However, the public relations partner for the African Brand Award, Wole Oyewo, in a chat with Infotech Network, explain the impact of perception on promoting African brand.
The first thing that can be done is the perception.
Okay.
We as Africans, and especially consumers, African consumers, we need to change our perception in terms of what is foreign is better than what is made locally.
Okay.
Right? What is produced, and especially companies that come, you know, foreign companies that come into our territory and bring in their products, we have to look at it and examine it and see that some of the products that we even produce first are superior. So when we change our perception and know that what they are bringing into Africa, we can also do it, and we can also produce these products and consume it ourselves, understand, and they'll be quite good, that will be the first thing that we should look at.
With around 40% of its 1.1 billion populations under the age of 30, provides Africa with a clear advantage over Europe, North America, and even China. If this record is anything to go by, indigenous companies must take their rightful position on the global scene for Africa to maximize this advantage. This is what the African Brands Award, TABA, is set to achieve.
The companies themselves have that particular role to play. It is their products, so they have to have the primary role of saying that, oh, these products are very good products. They've been tested in markets, and now we're bringing them here. After all, that's what all those companies are doing. And so we need to get away from this notion that government has to do something.
The companies need to enlighten the public that their products are of good quality. Now, with that, they'll be changing the perception of the consumers. Mm-hmm. The consumer is key, and the consumer is also king. Sure. He determines whether your product becomes a brand or it fizzles out of the market at the end of the day. Understand? And consumer loyalty, buying it, can be, it's not cheap. Mm-hmm. It's very expensive. Mm-hmm. Understand? So, but the companies are the first to make sure that there's a change in perception of consumer buying.
The annual African Brand Award is scheduled to take place on Friday, 18th of October at the prestigious Dorchester Park Lane, London, with its subsequent event in Africa and periodically outside Africa.